Antonia were young again. Just a dozen years or so.
It's locked, all right.
This is not the place for you, sir. Speak English, do ya?
Das war aber jetzt schwer.
Good evening, sir.
Who the fuck are you? Don't you see I'm busy here?
Dr. Jonathan Reed, that's who I am. And who are you?
Ah, some fancy gentleman we've got here. Clear off. We don't want strangers on our streets.
So you won't tell me your name, then?
The name is Booth Digby. Maybe I'll ask my boys to break one or two of your bones, just so you remember.
What can you tell me about this part of town?
Things ain't that bad, thanks to us. We give people what they need, and we control this borough.
Well, you're not doing a very good job. People are still dying here, like everywhere else.
Yeah, well, we can't be everywhere all the time. And Edwina says if we can find more guns, we could be more efficient.
More efficient? Really? You should probably tell Edwina that guns are useless against diseases and infections.
Incredible. You know what? You're lucky she can't hear you right now. She's more smart than patient. My sweet queen of the docks.
Are you some kind of vigilante patrolling these streets at night?
Something like that, but the police aren't in charge here. We are, see?
So, tell me about your gang, then.
What? Have you got a death wish? You really want me to answer that?
Well, yes. You seem so proud of your status. Why not tell me who you're working for?
Oi! I'm the boss, all right? The Wet Boot Boys work for me. All of them. Situation round here is better than other districts because of us. Because of me.
So you're a concerned criminal, is that it?
Using funny jokes about me and my boys, are you? Fuck. You must have some balls.
I saw many men like you during the war, Mr. Digby. Greedy little cockroaches who feed on despair.
I could kill you for saying that. But, nah. You've been a soldier. I can respect that.
Goodbye, Mr. Digby. Good evening, miss. I am Dr. Reed. May I ask you a few questions?
Who are you? What do you want?
As I just told you, I'm a doctor. From the Pembroke Hospital, actually.
The Pembroke Hospital, you say? I don't have any money for you leeches.
I'm not here for charity, miss...
Miss Edwina Cox. So what do you want, then? Fancy buying something from me, maybe?
Can I see what you have to sell?
As long as you have money, I'll show you all I have.
Thank you. Good evening, Miss Cox.
Hello again, Doc.
Booth Digby looks at you with love-struck eyes. Tell me, Edwina, is the feeling mutual?
You have no idea how refreshing it can be for a woman to receive all the pleasure she needs, for once.
I'll take your word for it.
What is it, Doctor? A woman's not supposed to talk about these things.
Behind all your crude words and your attitude, I sense romance and a soft heart, Miss Cox.
Romance? I have no time for such rubbish. I use Booth like I use everyone else.
Goodbye, Miss Cox.
Foolish girl and her pretty principles. She's got no idea who she's dealing with.
Thank you. losing my mind.
Dog's fault, they say. Then the gangs, the epidemics, everyone's throwing the blame.
Perhaps we should listen to what the idiot had to say first.